This is Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Elmo is happy you're here. And good thing too. It's time for another fun day in Elmo's world. Because today, Elmo is thinking about birds. Come on.
Oh look. They're here.
Oh good. Now we can start a new day in Elmo's world. So Elmo, what are you thinking about today?
Well Noah, today Elmo is thinking about birds. There are so many different kinds of birds.
Yeah, that's true. There are so many different kinds of birds. There are emus, penguins, peacocks, ostriches, all kinds of different birds. Hey, what kind of birds do you like?
Oh, that must be a good bird you like.
It sure is. Hey, you guys wanna know what my favorite kind of bird is?
Of course we do, Spot. What kind of bird is your favorite?
Play Spot's clues to figure it out.
Good idea. We can play Spot's clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is. We are gonna play Spot's clues, cause it's a really great game. Yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's clues. You know what we need for Spot's clues. Our handy dandy
notebook.
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's clues, we gotta find three.
Paw prints. One, two, three. And that's one of our
clues. Our clues?
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's clues. Spot's clues. You know what to do.
Sit down in our thinking chair.
Think.
Think.
Cause when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything.
Woof woof.
Bark 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 bark.
Ready to play Spot's clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is? You are? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, what do birds sound like?
Oh, that's a good question.
Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! The shade is trying to fly like the Blue Jay. Oh, thanks, Blue Jay. Fly up, Shade. Thank you.
Oh, there he is.
Hi, Mr. Noodle. Well, what's Mr. Noodle doing up there? Mr. Noodle is upside down. Come down, Mr. Noodle. Dorothy has a question. Oh. Are you okay, Mr. Noodle? Oh, that's good. So is Mr. Noodle ready for Dorothy's question? Good. Mr. Noodle, what do birds sound like?
What do birds sound like, Mr. Noodle?
Ring, ring.
No.
Ring, ring.
That's not a bird sound.
Ring, ring.
That's a telephone, not a bird.
What do birds sound like?
That's not a bird sound, Mr. Noodle. That's a fire engine. A fire engine, not a bird.
Not a bird? No, that's not a bird, Mr. Noodle. That sounds like a fire engine. Try again. That's a raspberry.
That's not a bird sound.
We want to know what birds sound like.
Birds go tweet tweet.
Ah, that sounds like a bird, Mr. Noodle.
That sounds like a duck.
Yeah, that sounds like a duck.
Quack, quack,
it worked. Quack, quack, a duck came.
Quack, 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 quack.
Yeah.
That's a bird.
A chicken.
A chicken is a bird.
A chicken is a bird, too.
A turkey, that's a bird.
And a bird.
Yeah. Boy, that's a lot of bird sounds.
And an owl. And a crow.
Very good, Mr. Noodle.
And another bird.
That's a lot of birds.
Amazing.
Yeah, he's very amazing. Well, we better start looking for clues. Come on.
A clue.
You see a clue? Is it behind us or in front of us?
Behind you.
Oh, there is a clue. On the colors black and white. Looks like black and white are our first clue. We need our handy dandy.
Notebook,
right. And I'll use two different colored crayons for this clue. So a curvy shape that we can color it in for white, then we use our black crayon for this shape. There, black and white. Okay. So our first clue is black and white.
So what could Spot's favorite kind of bird be with black and white?
Yeah, maybe. But I think we should find two more clues, just to be sure.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends, just got an email.
Oh look, it's an email from Terrence and Trip.
Hi guys, Trip and I are bird watching.
Look, there are two birds over there in that tree, a blue one and a red one. How cool is that?
So cool. Bye guys.
Bye.
Thanks computer.
Bird watching really is a nice thing to like about birds.
Speaking of birds, Elmo has a question about birds.
Oh, what's the bird question, Elmo?
Elmo wants to know how many birds are going to land on this tree. Let's count them and see.
All right. Count with us. 1,
2,
3, 4,
5. 5 birds have landed on the tree.
Wow. 5 birds. Great counting, everybody.
Come on! Let's go find Spot.
Hey guys! Glad you came. It's time for a new drawer game. A drawer game about birds.
Ooh. This sounds like fun. Be careful opening the drawer, Elmo.
Elmo will. Wah-ah.
Not again.
Ooh. What pretty colored nests.
And what nice colored eggs. Is this part of the game, Spot?
It sure is. So, in this game, you need to find the right colored nest to put each of the different colored eggs back into their bird's nest.
Oh, okay. Will you help us with this? Great. All right, let's see. We'll start with the brown egg. Which nest does the brown egg belong in?
That one.
That one, right. The brown egg is the same color as the brown nest. So, the brown egg belongs in the brown nest. Great job.
Excellent. Okay, you figured out which nest the brown egg belongs in. Now let's do the light blue egg. Can you figure out which nest the light blue egg belongs in?
Let's see. Which nest do you think the light blue egg belongs in?
That one.
Oh yeah, that one. Because the light blue nest is the same color as the egg. Okay, now let's do the pink one. Where does the pink egg belong in?
That one.
Pink egg, pink nest. Perfect match. We did it. We matched the right colored eggs with the nests. Great job.
Wow. Great color matching. You did great.
Yeah. Great job, everybody. You did a great job. Well, that's it for today's drawer game. Thanks for playing. Until next time.
So, Elmo, are you okay?
Yeah, Elmo's okay.
Oh, good. Well, We did a great job matching the eggs. Thanks for your help. Come on, we better keep on looking for clues.
A clue! A clue!
Yeah, that really was a good drawer game we played today. I wonder how Spot keeps coming up with these ideas.
No, a clue!
A clue? Where?
Behind you!
Oh, there is a clue. And it's ice. Hey, Sailor Moon, let's draw this clue together.
Good idea, Alex. I'll go first. So, we draw the outline for a block of ice. Then some squiggly lines inside. There, ice.
Okay. My turn. So we draw the outline for a block of ice. Then some squiggly lines on the inside. There, ice.
So, we're trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is. What was our first clue?
Black and white.
Right, black and white.
And now we have ice. So what could Spot's favorite kind of bird be, with black and white, and ice?
That's what I think too. But maybe we should find our last clue to figure this out.
Watch a channel.
Watch a channel. That's right. We always watch a channel when Elmo wants to learn more about something.
Yeah. Elmo and his friends can watch the bird channel.
The Bird Channel. All birds, all the time. We're strictly for the birds.
Hi there. It's me, the bird lady. I love bird watching. In fact, I'm looking for some birds to watch right now. Whoa! I see some birds over there. Chickens. And they're doing the chicken dance. Hey, let's all do the chicken dance. It's easy. And you don't have to be a chicken to do it. You just pretend to be one. Here's what you do. First, you pretend your hands are beaks, like this. Cluck, 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 cluck. Very beaky. Now pretend your arms are wings, like this. Flap, 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 flap. Good flapping. Now shake your tail feathers, like this. Shake, 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 shake. Now clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap. All right, you're ready to do the chicken dance. Let's go. Clap, 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 shake, 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 clap, 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 shake, 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 clap, 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 shake, 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 clap, 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 shake, 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 clap, 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 clap. That's it. Go on, everybody. You've got three rings. Looking good. Oh, watch out! You're the wind beneath my wings! Shake that booty! Omelets for all! Omelets for all! Cluck, 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 cluck! Shake, 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 shake! Shake, 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 shake! Cluck, 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 cluck! Cluck, 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 cluck! Shake, 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 shake! Shake, 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 shake! You all make great chickens! You make great chickens, too! See you next time! Cluck, 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 cluck! Shake, 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 shake!
Coming up next on the Bird Channel, The Lone Ranger, starring Walter Pigeon.
Bark. Bark, bark, bark.
That sure was great. Thanks, TV.
Come on. Let's go find Spot.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Spot just went right into that computer game. Let's go to Spot's Skydo. We can too.
Wow. We're on the farm.
Oh look. It's a hen. A hen is a kind of bird.
Hello there. I'm the little red hen. It's very nice to meet you.
The little red hen? From that story? The little red hen?
That's me. And I could really use your help. You see, I'm trying to bake some fresh bread. But some of the animals I asked won't help me. Watch. Excuse me, duck. Can you please help me bake some bread?
Nope. Not I.
Will you help me bake some bread, cat?
Not I.
Will you help me bake bread, dog?
Not I.
See? No one will help me.
Oh no. Well, don't worry. Elmo and friends can help the little red hen.
Really? You'll help me?
Of course we can help. Will you help too? Great.
Fantastic. Okay, so first, we'll need some wheat to make some bread. Follow me. Okay. Here's the wheat. This is the first thing we need to make some bread.
Okay. But we'll need something to cut the wheat. What can we use to cut the wheat?
Do you know what we can use?
That one.
This one, right. It's called a sickle. Farmers use this to cut the wheat. We can use this to cut the wheat. There. The wheat is cut. Great job. Now all we need to do is go down to the mill to turn the wheat into flour. Come on. Excuse me. Who will help us take this wheat to the mill to be ground into flour?
Not I. Not I.
Not I.
Oh. Then we'll do it ourselves.
There's the mill. This is where we turn the wheat into flour. Come on. Okay. So this machine here will help us turn the wheat into flour. Ready? Here it goes. Here we are. One bag of flour. Now there's one more thing to do. And that is to bake bread from this nice white flour. Who will help us make some bread?
Not I. Not I.
Not I. Oh. Then, we will.
All right. Wait out here while I bake the bread.
Wow. I can hardly wait to taste some of that delicious bread.
Elmo too. Elmo's sort of feeling a little hungry.
So am I. I'd like to have some of that bread.
Bark, bark.
Here we are. Some tasty, delicious bread.
Mmm. That bread smells so good.
Yes, it does. Who will help me eat this bread?
I will. I will.
I will.
Them? Did they help the little red hen and us at all?
No!
No. They most certainly did not.
That's right. You did not help us cut the wheat. You didn't help us take the wheat to be ground into flour. And, you did not help us bake the bread. So, me and my new friends are going to eat the bread ourselves. Thank you guys so much for helping me bake some bread. I would not have cut the wheat, grounding it into flour, and baking the bread without your help. Please have some bread as a token of my thanks.
Thank you very much, little red hen. And here's a slice for you too. You got it? Great.
Thanks again for your help.
You're welcome. Come on.
L-A, 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 L-A. Thanks, computer.
A clue, a clue!
Huh? Did we leave something behind at the farm?
No, a clue!
A clue?
Oh, there is a clue. But, what is it doing?
Waddling.
Waddling? Wow, that's really something.
Which means Elmo can draw the clue with his handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right. So, how does Elmo draw waddling? Elmo will draw little footsteps with some ovals here, like this. And then Elmo will draw some lines with a motion. There, a waddling motion. Hey, Elmo and his friends have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is.
All three clues. You know what that means. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair. Let's go.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay. So we're trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bird is. And our clues are, black and white.
Eyes.
And,
watermelon.
So what do you think Spot's favorite kind of bird is, with black and white eyes and waddling?
Well, there's a kind of bird that's black and white, and maybe it lives on ice.
Yeah, Elmo thinks that too. But what about the waddling motion?
Well, maybe there's a kind of bird that could waddle on the ice. But what kind of bird is black and white, lives on the ice, and waddles around?
A penguin.
A penguin. Yeah, that's it. Spot's favorite kind of bird is a penguin.
Yeah, because penguins are black and white, they live on the ice in the Arctic, and they can waddle around in the ice. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart. Wow, Spot, I had no idea that a penguin was your favorite kind of bird.
They sure are. Penguins are my favorite kind of birds. Let me show you why I like them. So here's what I love about penguins. They live in Antarctica, one of the coldest places in the world. And the penguins' feathers are like a special coat that keeps them warm and dry. Wow. Elmo didn't know that about penguins. Can they flap their wings and fly? No. Penguins don't fly. They use their wings like flippers, so they can swim.
Oh yeah. We forgot that there are some birds that don't fly. And penguins are one of the birds that don't fly.
That's right. There's some flightless birds. Like penguins for an example. I wonder what other birds there are that don't fly.
Oh look. Dorothy is imagining Elmo as a penguin.
Penguins can't fly, but they can swim. First, they slide on the ice. Then they splash into the water. Some birds can't swim or fly, like peacocks. But they still have a lot of feathers.
Wow, cool, huh?
Wow, that's some imagining Dorothy does. And wow, what a day this has been. Thank you so much for all your help today.
Yeah, it was so much fun. And now before we go, Elmo wants to sing the bird song. Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Look at what Elmo is reading in this book. Elmo is reading a book about bugs. Because bugs are what Elmo is thinking about today.
Bugs? Did somebody say bugs?
There aren't any actual bugs in Elmo's world, Alex. Elmo was just telling our friend that he's thinking about bugs.
Oh, you're thinking about bugs today. Well, that's good.
Yeah. There are lots of different kinds of bugs. Like ants, and bumblebees. Like what Elmo's looking at.
And there's also a beetle, and a ladybug too.
And even a cricket, and flies. There are lots of different kinds of bugs to look at. Hey, do you have a favorite kind of bug?
Oh. That must be a really great bug you like to look at.
Yeah, it must be. Ooh, does Spot have a favorite kind of bug too? Yes, I do. There's a certain kind of bug I like.
Oh, really? What kind of bug is that?
You'll have to play Spot's Clues to figure it out.
What a bug-tastic idea. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is. We love Spot's Clues. We are going to play Spots Clues, because it's a really great game. Yeah, okay, now remember. Spots Paw Prints will be on the clues. Spots Clues.
Oh look, the paw print turned itself into a yellow butterfly. Nice, Spots.
You know what we need to play Spots Clues, our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we got to find three
pockets.
Pockets. One, two, three. And that's one of our
clues. Our clues?
And then we put it in our notebook. Because there's Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues. You know what to do. Sit down in your thinking chair.
Think.
Think.
Because when we use our minds, take a step back in time. Do anything.
What?
That you want to do.
Ready to play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is? You are? Great.
Ooh, what's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
Bark, 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 bark.
Dorothy wants to know, what does a caterpillar turn into when it grows up?
Oh, that's a good question. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Why don't we call him? On my notebook phone. Calling. Hello, Mr. Noodle. Are you ready for Dorothy's question? What does a caterpillar turn into when it grows up?
Now Mr. Noodle will show us what a caterpillar turns into when it grows up. A rabbit? No, Mr. Noodle. A cowboy? Mr. Noodle. That's right! A caterpillar turns into a butterfly when it grows up. Watch out, Mr. Noodle!
Bye, Mr. Noodle.
That Mr. Noodle. Always very silly. Even when it comes to answering Dorothy's questions.
Yeah. The Noodle family is a very silly family. Well, now that we're done with Dorothy's question, it's time to start looking for those clues. Come on!
A clue, a clue!
A bug clue? What's a bug clue?
No, a clue!
A clue? Where?
Oh, there is a clue. And it's wings. Those wings from that plane must be our first clue.
Oh boy. Noah and I can draw this clue together. I'll go first. First, let's draw a curved shape that's flat on one end, and another one like this. There, wings.
Okay, my turn. So we draw a curved shape that's flat on one end, and another one like this. There, wings.
Alright. So what could Spot's favorite kind of bug be with wings?
Ooh, that could be it. But maybe we should find two more clues. Just to be sure.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends, just got an email.
We just got an email.
We wonder who it's from.
Oh look. It's an email from Chibi USA and Chibi Chibi.
Hi guys. I was about to tell Chibi Chibi one of her favorite nursery rhymes about a bug. And it's called Little Miss Muffet. And it goes like this. Little Miss Muffet sat on her tuffet, eating her curds and whey. And along came a spider, who sat down beside her, and frightened Miss Muffet away.
Hey, hey, hey!
Oh, hi, spider. Would you like some curds and whey?
Well, I prefer yogurt and granola, but that'll do.
Oh, okay. Well, that's the end of the nursery rhyme. See you later, guys.
Bye-bye!
Bye.
Thanks, computer.
should be USA's right. Little Miss Muffet's nursery rhyme does have a bug in it. And spiders are definitely bugs.
Yeah, that's true. Speaking of bugs, Elmo has a question about bugs.
A bug question? What kind of bug question is it?
Elmo's question is about our little ladybug friend. So, Elmo wants to know, how many spots are on this ladybug? Let's count and see.
All right. Count with us. One spot.
Two spots.
Three spots. Four spots.
Bark, bark.
Six spots.
Seven spots. Eight spots. So, how many spots does our little ladybug friend have?
Eight spots.
Eight spots, right. Four spots on one side, and four more on the other side. Add all four of them together, and that gives us eight spots.
Wow. Eight spots together. Wow. Thanks, ladybug. Oh, good. You're all here. And good thing, too. Because it's time for today's drawer.
Oh, boy. Is today's drawer game about bugs?
How do you know?
Just a thought.
Come on, drawer. Wah-ah.
Oh, come on.
Ooh, what's this spot? These are some homes to different kinds of bugs. So, in this game, you need to help three different kinds of bugs find their homes.
Oh, okay. Will you help find the bugs' homes? Great.
So here are the bugs you need to help. You have a spider, a bee, and an ant. So first, let's help the spider.
Okay. So which of these homes does the spider live in? The ant hill, the beehive, or the spider web?
That one.
The spider web. That's right. Spiders live in a spider web. Because a spider is made by a spider. Great job.
All right. We helped the spider get home. Now let's help this little bee get home. So, which of these homes does the bee live in?
That one.
A beehive. That's right. Bees live in hives. They live in hives, so that they can make honeycombs. Excellent job.
Okay. Now let's help the ant. Where does the ant live?
Right there.
That's right. The ant lives in an anthill. Great job.
Hey, wait a minute. You said there were only three bugs to help. But we see only four choices. What kind of bug lives there?
Oh, Elmo knows this one. That's Ernie's window box. That's where his twiddle bugs live.
Oh, so that's what kind of bugs live in Ernie's window box.
Oh, I wonder what the twiddle bugs are up to today. Hark, do I hear singing?
Wow. That was really great. Lots of bugs in the world that lives in lots of different homes.
Yeah. That's really cool.
It sure is. Well, that's it for today's drawer game. Thanks for playing. Until next time.
Wow. There really are lots of different homes for lots of different kinds of bugs.
Yeah. It's really amazing. Don't you think? Well, we better keep on looking for clues. Come on.
A clue.
Yeah. It's really cool to know what kind of homes bugs lives.
No, it's a clue.
Oh, you see a clue? Where?
Behind you.
Oh, there's a clue. On those colors. Red, green, and orange. Okay, we need our handy dandy.
Notebook.
Right. And since this clue is all three colors, we'll use three different kinds of crayons. We'll hold all three crayons together and make some swirls like this. There, colors. Okay. So we need to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is.
And our first clue is wings.
And now our second clue is colors.
Wings and colors. Elmo wonders what kind of bug Spot likes with these clues.
Oh, that's a good idea. But let's find our last clue and see if we're right.
Well, with all this talk about bugs, Elmo still wants to learn more about them. How can Elmo find out more? Look. The TV. Oh yeah. TV always helps Elmo and friends. We can watch the Bug Channel.
Bug Channel, crawling into your home. And now, it's time for the Bug Lady.
Hi there, I'm the Bug Lady. I love bugs. You know what my favorite bug is? Ants! Look at those cute little ants. Do they have uncles? I have a great ant song that I'm going to teach you now, and we can all sing it. And you can march to it, too, like this. It's a marching song. And you sing hurrah! Let me hear it. Hurrah! Hurrah! Great. Everybody ready? Here we go! The ants go marching one by one. Hurrah! Hurrah! The ants go marching one by one. Hurrah! Hurrah! The ants go marching one by one. The little ones stop to suck his thumb, and they all go marching down into the ground. Marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah! The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah! The ants go marching two by two. The little one stops to tie his shoe, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom! The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah! The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah! The ants go marching three by three. The little ones stop to climb a tree, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom! That was great. Now I'm gonna march inside and get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom!
Wow, that was really good.
It sure was. Thanks, TV.
Come on, let's go find Spot.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Hey, Spot Sky Dude into that book.
Bark. Bark, 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 bark.
A big bug book? You know this book?
Bark, bark, bark.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go to Spot Sky Dude. We can too.
Wow. Elmo has never seen such big trees before. Those aren't trees, Elmo. It's grass.
Grass? Oh my goodness. That is grass. We're really small. Just like bugs.
Oh wow. Now we'll get to see what it's like to be a bug.
Whoa. That's a really big ant. Hi. I'm Antoinette. I'm a worker ant. Today's my first day on the job. And I think I need some help.
Oh, of course we can help. Do you wanna help Antoinette? You do. Great.
All right. Lead the way.
Okay. So first I have to find some food to bring back home.
But how does an ant look for food?
I don't know. We didn't learn anything about that back home. Let's figure out how Antoinette can look for food.
Let's watch that other ant over there. What does that other ant use to find its food?
Its antenna.
Oh, its antenna. That must be how ants look for their food. Antoinette, try using your antenna to find your food.
All right. Oh, that crumb is the perfect food for me to bring back home.
Great. Let me help you carry it. Alex, give me a hand.
Wow. That's really big and heavy. We can't even lift it. And it's just a crumb.
Wow. Antoinette lifted that crumb. Why do you think she did that?
She's strong.
That's right. I am strong. I'm going to carry this crumb all the way home.
Wow. Ants are strong little insects.
This is my home. The ant hill. Come on.
First time in an ant hill.
This is the ant colony.
Wow. Nice colony.
Yeah. And everybody's got a job to do. Wow. Look at all the rooms here in the anthill. That room here is where they take care of the babies. This is the food storage room. Come on. We did it. Thanks for helping me bring some food back home.
You're welcome, Antoinette. And thank you for helping us.
Now I want to bring some food to my mom. There she is. That big ant over there is my mom. She's the leader of the entire colony.
Really? Well, what do you think Antoinette's mom is called, if she's the leader of the entire colony?
The queen.
Right, the queen. She must be the queen ant.
Oh, thank you. How was your first day on the job?
You're very welcome, Your Highness. Come on.
L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A-L-A.
Ah, it's great to be big again.
It sure is.
A clue! A clue!
You see our last clue? Where?
Right there!
Oh, there is a clue. On this. This. What is this?
A chrysalis.
A chrysalis? What's a chrysalis?
Maybe the kind of bug Spot likes comes from a chrysalis. Well, we better write it down. Elmo, it's your turn.
Right, Noah. So, a chrysalis. Let's draw a line with a big oval shape. And then some curved lines across, like this. There, a chrysalis. Hey, Elmo and his friends have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is. We're ready for our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair. Come on. Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay. We are trying to figure out what Spot's favorite kind of bug is. And our clues are wings,
colors,
and a chrysalis. Well, maybe there's a certain kind of bug Spot likes that has some colorful wings.
Yeah, and maybe the bug could come out of the chrysalis.
Oh yeah. So, if there's bug Spot likes that has wings with some colors and comes out of a chrysalis, then what kind of bug would that be?
A butterfly.
A butterfly. Yeah, that's it. Because a butterfly has wings with colors, and it's in a chrysalis when it changes from a caterpillar into a butterfly.
Wow. Elmo loves butterflies too. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart. Wow, Spot. I didn't know you liked looking at butterflies.
Yeah. Butterflies are my favorite kind of bugs. Because I like how colorful they are, and how they come in different patterns.
Yeah, butterflies are really nice. There are lots of butterflies with pretty colors and patterns. You can find them anywhere. Either in your backyard, a park, or anywhere else.
Bark. Bark, bark, bark.
Oh look. Dorothy is imagining Elmo as bugs.
Elmo's Worldwide Web!
Hey, who turned out the light?
Fireflies make a light.
Oh, Elmo is the light!
Bees make honey.
How sweet it is.
Wow. Dorothy's pretty good at imagining Elmo to be lots of things.
She sure is. And wow, what a bugtastic day. Thanks for joining Elmo and friends on our bug day. And now before we go, Elmo wants to sing the bug song. Mind if I join? Of course, Antoinette. Here we go.
Bye.
This is Elmo's world. Elmo is so happy to see you. And so is Dorothy. Say hi, Dorothy. Elmo's so glad you're here. Because it's time for another fun day in Elmo's world. Come on, let's go join Elmo's friends. Hey guys, our friend is here.
Oh hi. Are you ready for another fun day in Elmo's world? I hope so, cause we are too.
Yeah. We can't wait. So Elmo, do you know what you're thinking about today?
Yes, Alex. Today, Elmo is thinking about bicycles.
Bark. Bark, bark, bark.
Bicycles. Now there's something fun to think about. Bicycles are a fun thing to have. Because they're fun to ride on, and to get around.
Yeah. There are different kinds of bicycles. There are unicycles, tricycles, all kinds of bicycles. But they're not just for having fun. They're also good for exercising and racing. Hey, what do you like to do with a bicycle?
Ooh, that's a good thing to like about bicycles. It sure is. Everybody must have a favorite thing to do with a bicycle. Even I have a favorite thing.
Oh? What's your favorite thing to do with a bicycle?
Play Spots Clues to figure it out.
Oh, okay. We'll play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite thing to do with the bicycle is. We are gonna play Spot's Clues, cause it's a really great game, yeah. So remember, Spot's paw prints will be on the clues. Spot's Clues. Alright, you know what we need to play Spot's Clues, our handy dandy.
Notebook,
right.
Come on. Let's open the drawer and see what's inside. Oh, here it is. You know, Elmo and his friends are really gonna need your help today, trying to figure out what Spot's favorite thing about bicycles is. Will you help? You will? Great.
To play Spot's Clues, we gotta find three.
Paw prints. 1, 2, 3. And that's one of our clues.
Our clues?
A clue.
And then we put it in our notebook. Because they're Spot's Clues. Spot's Clues. You know what to do.
Sit down in our clue chair. And
think.
Think.
Cause when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything.
Woof woof. That we wanna do.
Ready to play Spot's Clues to figure out what Spot's favorite thing to do with the bicycle is? You are? Great.
Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Elmo will ask the question.
What did she say, Elmo?
Dorothy wants to know, how do you ride a bike?
Oh, that's a good question.
Let's ask Mr. Nerdo! Mr. Nerdo! Oh, nice day, Shay! Now go up, please! Stay up, Shay! Come on, Shay! Stay up, please! Oh, thank you!
Oh, there he is.
Hi, Mr. Nerdo! Mr. Nerdo! Oh, Mr. Nerdo, Dorothy has a question for you. Is Mr. Nerdo ready for Dorothy's question now? Oh, good.
How do you ride a bicycle, Mr. Nerdo?
A bicycle.
You'll need the helmet.
A helmet protects your head.
Very good, Mr. Nerdo. You have to wear a helmet when you ride a bike.
But you need a bicycle.
Go get a bicycle, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle!
That's for little kids.
You're too big.
No, that's too small for you. That's a tricycle, not a bicycle.
You need a bicycle. A bicycle.
A two-wheeler.
That's better.
That's the right size bicycle.
Now, how do you ride it?
Get on a bike!
No!
Turn around, Mr. Nerdo!
Not the bike. Turn yourself around.
You need to turn yourself around and face the other way on the bicycle.
Yeah, like that.
Mr. Noodle, come on. No, no, ride the bike. No. Mr. Noodle! No!
Put your feet on the pedals and push.
That's the pedals.
Now push.
One foot on?
Now put your other foot on the pedal.
And the other foot, Mr. Noodle. You can do it.
He's doing it.
Yeah, now pedal. Keep pedaling.
He's a little shaky.
Yay! That's great, Mr. Noodle.
Stop, Mr. Noodle.
You can stop now, Mr. Noodle.
He can't stop.
Does Mr. Noodle know how to stop?
Stop.
Uh-oh.
Are you okay, Mr. Noodle?
I think the bike is broken.
Well, he almost had it.
Yeah, that was a good try. But at least he did it. Come on, we better start looking for clues.
A clue, a clue!
You see our first clue? Where?
Behind you.
Behind you!
Oh, there is a clue. On the neighborhood. You know what we need, our handy dandy.
Notebook!
Notebook, right. Let's draw a line for some hills for the houses. One house here, and another one here. Then we'll draw two pathways for the houses. And there, the neighborhood. So what do you think Spot's favorite thing to do with bicycles is, with the neighborhood?
Yeah, maybe. But I think we need to find two more clues. Just to be sure.
Well, in the meantime, Elmo has a question. For you guys, and you.
Ooh. What's today's question, Elmo?
Elmo wants to know, how many bike riders can ride this bike?
There you are! Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten!
There's a chicken! That's ten! Yes, 10 bike riders on a bicycle built for 10! Great counting, everyone!
Wow. With a bike like that, you really need 10 people to ride together on that kind of bike.
Yeah. That kind of bike is called a 10-person bike. There are different kinds of bicycles like that. Come on!
Hey guys. It's time for a brand new drawer game. Are you guys ready?
We're ready. And hopefully if Drawer doesn't push Elmo again.
Don't worry. I'm gonna be with him this time. Come on, Elmo. Okay. On the count of three, we...
Wah-ah.
Bark, bark.
Hey, that's Mona.
Yep. She's on her motor scooter, and she's delivering pizza to Elmo's world. Huh? Elmo didn't order pizza. That's not the point. So, in this game, you need to help Mona finding the shortest route, so the pizza won't get cold.
Oh, okay. Will you help us find the shortest route for Mona? You will? Great. How do we know which path we think she needs to take?
View the pictures on the map, and figure out the shortest route to Elmo's world.
Alright, so let's figure this out. If Mona needs to find the shortest route to Elmo's world to deliver pizza, which path do you think would be the shortest route?
That one.
An apple? Oh. That must be Apple Street. So, if she needs to go that way, which other way would she go?
That way!
This way? Oh, look at that. That must be Pig Street. Alright, so it looks like the quickest route to Elmo's world is Apple Street and Pig Street. I think we figured it out.
You did it. You figured it out. Great job.
Great job. We figured out the quickest route to get Mona to Elmo's world. And that's quite the motor scooter she's got.
Pizza delivery.
Oh wow. How do you like that? We helped Mona find the shortest route to Elmo's world, and here she is.
Yeah. That really was a good drawer game. Thanks for the pizzas, Mona.
You're welcome, guys. Have a good day.
Well, that's it for today's drawer game. Thanks for playing. Until next time. Elmo didn't know there would be a motor scooter.
Sure is. Mona uses that motor scooter to deliver pizza. So I guess a motor scooter, or a regular scooter, would be a kind of bicycle. Don't you think? Well, we better keep on looking for clues. Come on!
A clue! A clue!
You want some of that pizza too? Well, that's gonna have to wait for now.
No, a clue right there!
Oh, you saw a clue. Now I see. There's a clue on this sidewalk. Who's gonna draw this clue?
Me. I'll draw this clue. We'll draw two horizontal lines here, and some vertical lines connecting together like this. There, a sidewalk.
Okay, so our first clue is the neighborhood.
And now we have a sidewalk.
So what do you think Spot's favorite thing about bicycles is, with the neighborhood and the sidewalk?
Oh, that's what Elmo thinks too.
Yeah, but let's find our last clue to figure this out.
Elmo has mail!
Hey, Elmo and his friends just got an email.
Oh look, it's an email from Ivy.
Hi guys. I'm about to start riding my bike on my own for the first time. Dad, this is for you and Mom. I did it. I did it. I rode my bike for the first time. Bye guys.
Bye Ivy. Way to go.
Thanks computer.
That's my girl. She rode her bike on her own for the very first time.
Yay for Ivy. And now, Elmo wants to learn even more about bicycles. Don't you?
And we know what to do about that, don't we?
Watch a channel.
Watch a channel, right. Elmo and friends can watch the Bicycle Channel.
The Bicycle Channel. All bicycles, all the time. Ride on. And now, our spokesperson.
Hello there, bicycle fans. Guess what? I love bicycles. You know why? Because they're fun! Fun to ride. Whee! Fun to go places on. Whoopee! Fun to exercise on. Feeling the burn. They're even fun to sing about. Hey, let's sing a song about a bike now. You may know this song already about a bus. I changed it to a bike because I love bikes! You ready? Oh! The wheels on the bike go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bike go round and round all through the town. The bell on the bike goes ding, 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 ding. The bell on the bike goes ding, ding, ding all through the town. The handlebars on the bike go turn, 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 turn. The bars on the bike go turn, turn, turn all through the town. The person on the bike goes up and down, up and down, up and down. The person on the bike goes up and down all through the town. That was great. And now I'm going to ride my bike all through the town. See you next time.
Coming up next on the Bicycle Channel, the Dick Van Bike Show.
Now that was a good channel. She changed the wheels on the bus to the wheels on the bike. How interesting.
It sure was. Thanks, TV.
That sounds like the sound of Spot's guy doing. Come on! Oh, there's Spot. He just skydued into that storybook. Come on! Let's go to Spot Skydoo. We can too.
Oh look, there's a bear and a wheel. I wonder what story this is.
This story is called Bears on Wheels. It's about this bear riding on these wheels when other bears come.
Oh, That's a unicycle. That's only big enough for one person, or bear. Maybe this will help us learn more about bicycles. Let's read the story. Will you read with us? Great. Okay, so the beginning of the story goes, one bear, one wheel.
Yeah. Look. There's the bear, and there's the wheel.
But then what happens next?
Well, the only way to figure that out is to turn the page.
Wow. That was cool. Oh, and look. The bear is riding on the wheel. That's what the next line says. One bear, on one wheel.
Oh yeah. He's on that wheel all right. Oh, and look. There's another bear up ahead. I wonder what's going to happen. Do you know what might happen? You think so? Let's see. Turn the page.
Bark. Bark, bark, bark.
Yeah. That other bear hopped on top of the wheel with the other bear. So now the story says, two bears, on one wheel.
But now there are two more bears up ahead. So what's gonna happen now?
Let's find out. Turn the page.
Oh my. Look at that. Three on one, four on one. This story is really something.
Yeah. Elmo wonders how many more bears can be on that wheel. Let's keep reading.
Yeah. Turn the page.
Uh-oh. The four bears are heading to this bear on that bike. The story now says, four bears on one wheel, one bear on two wheels.
Ooh. What do you think will happen now? Let's see. Turn the page.
The three bears are now on the bike with two wheels. So now the story says, four on two, one on one again.
Great. That bear is the only one on that wheel again. And those three bears are now on that bear's bike. I wonder what's gonna happen now.
Only one way to find out. Let's keep on reading, and find out what happens next. Turn the page.
Oh look. Those three bears are on a three-person bicycle. And they're heading straight for the bear on the wheel.
And this part of the story goes, one on one, three on three. One bear on a unicycle, and three bears on a three-person bicycle. What do you think is gonna happen next? You think so? Let's see. Turn the page.
Oh no. The bears rode into each other, and fell off. Now the story says, nine on four, four on nine. Let's see what happens next. Turn the page. Oh yay. The little bear is back on the unicycle. One on one again. So he's back on his wheel.
Alright. Looks like nothing is gonna stop him now. Let's see what happens next. Turn the page.
Hubba-wa. Where did those five bears come from?
The tree.
They must have been waiting for the bear to pass by so they get the jump on him. Now the story says, 5-on-1. This doesn't look good. Let's see what's gonna happen next. Turn the page.
What are those bears doing on that building?
I'm not sure. Let's see. From what we're seeing here. According to the story, we have 5 bears on 1, and 5 bears on none. So, if there are 5 bears on 1, and 5 bears on that building, how many bears are gonna be on the wheel now? Let's see. Turn the page. 10 bears on 1. Wow. That bear must be really good at riding that unicycle.
Yeah, let's see what else is gonna happen with those bears now. Turn the page.
Whoa. Is that a bike with 5 wheels?
I think so. I didn't know there would be a bike like that. This part of the story says, one bear on 5 wheels. And he's moving very fast on it.
Yeah. Look how fast he's going. Ooh, and I think I know what's gonna happen. Turn the page.
1 on 5, 10 on 1, 10 on 10. Wow, lots of bears on a lot of bicycles. What's gonna happen now? Turn the page.
21 on 9. Wow. The bear on 5 wheels. The 10 bears on 1, and the 10 bears on 10 rammed into each other, and got knocked off their bicycles. Can you believe that? Let's see what's next. Turn the page.
One on one again.
Wow! Look at that! We read the entire book, all the way to the end. Wow, what a great story! Thanks for reading the story with us.
And Elmo learned a lot about bicycles in this story. Elmo's glad. That's good. Well, looks like our work here is done. Come on, let's skidoo back to Elmo's world.
Oh yeah. We still need to figure out Spot's favorite thing about bicycles. Come on.
A clue, a clue!
You see our last clue? Where?
Right there!
Oh wow! Our third clue is a bicycle. We've been learning about bicycles, and now it's our third clue. What are the odds?
Well, it looks like me and Elmo will draw this clue together. I'll go first. Let's draw two circles, with smaller ones on the inside. A line with a curve, and a line here with an oval for the seat. There, a bicycle. Okay. Elmo's turn. So Elmo will draw two circles with smaller ones on the inside. Then handle, and then seat. There, a bicycle. Hey, we have all three clues to figure out what Spot's favorite thing to do with a bicycle is.
All three clues. You know what that means. We're ready to sit in our
thinking chair.
Thinking chair, right? Come on.
Now that we're in our thinking chair, let's think.
Okay. So we need to figure out what Spot's favorite thing to do with the bicycle is. And our clues are the neighborhood,
a sidewalk,
and a bicycle.
So what do you think Spot's favorite thing to do with a bicycle is, with the neighborhood, a sidewalk, and a bicycle?
Well, maybe Spot could ride his bicycle on the sidewalk. And when there's a sidewalk, there's a neighborhood.
Oh yeah, that sounds like something he would do. But what could you do on a bicycle, riding on the sidewalk, throughout the neighborhood?
Riding his bike through the neighborhood.
Riding his bike through the neighborhood. Yeah, that's it. Spot's favorite thing to do with a bicycle is to ride his bicycle throughout the neighborhood. I've seen him do it many times. We just figured out Spot's clues.
We just figured out Spot's clues. Because we're really smart.
Wow, Spot. You like to ride your bike throughout the neighborhood?
Yeah. That's my favorite thing about bicycles. I like to ride it throughout the neighborhood.
Bark, bark, bark.
You too, Blue? Wow, we both have the same thing in common.
Wow. That is great. So, Elmo, do you think you've learned enough about bicycles, or do you still need to know more?
Well, Elmo did enjoy learning about bicycles, but Elmo still wants to learn even more about bicycles.
You want to talk to a bicycle?
Yeah, we can talk to a bicycle.
Not without me.
Oh, and a helmet.
I go everywhere bicycle goes. I protect your head. You never get on a bike without me.
Oh, well, I'm gonna remember that. Good. Helmet. Thanks, helmet. Oh, now it's your turn, bicycle.
Oh, funny you should mention turn. See, you can turn me with my handlebars, see?
Oh, oh nice.
You can also pedal my pedals here and make me go slowly.
Oh, she's going slow.
That's slow.
Or fast.
Fast, very fast.
That's fast.
Fast is great if you want to be in a bicycle race.
Oh, you can race on a bicycle?
Sure.
Not without me.
Wow. There really are so many things you can do on a bicycle. I wonder what else you can do on a bicycle.
Oh, look. Dorothy is imagining Elmo racing on a bicycle.
Deliver newspapers on a bicycle.
Not without me.
Good morning, sir. Here's your newspaper. The
you.
You can also ride a unicycle. Unicycles are great for riding in the circus and doing tricks.
Not without me.
One, two, three. Huh? Ta-da!
Wow. Thanks, Bicycle.
My pleasure. Well, I gotta be pedaling along.
Not without me.
Bye, Elmo.
Bye. Thanks for coming.
Wow. What a great day. A great day to learn about what we do with a bicycle.
It sure was. Thank you so much for spending another day here in Elmo's world. And hey, maybe we should all get together sometime to ride our bikes around the neighborhood.
Elmo would like that. And now before we go, Elmo wants to sing the bicycle song.